Good morning, friends. Once in a while, I'm reminded by the Facebook in the memory section of some thoughts that I posted many years ago, and I came across one today in English, which I would like to share for the sake of amusement and maybe some deep consideration of some truths. This is something that I said about 5 years ago, because somebody asked me once, why, if there's order in the universe, why do we need idiots and ignoramuses in the world? Well, it may sound as an oxymoron, but ignorance is prerequisite to human development. We fulfill our purpose in the universe just as the way we are. For if there is order in the universe, as there is in the microcosm of our brains through which we think, then everything can be relatively broken down to explain things. Just as we fulfill, as we only have conscious access to a small percentage of our brain, and I state conscious access, so may the universe think through only a small fraction of the intelligent life forms it produces to give it conscience. The cosmos may feel bliss and control its motor actions through its ignorant, incapable of high thought creatures, those who focus on the basest faculties of the below the chest faculties, whilst it addresses higher thoughts through that small percentage of the human populace who can really think within the realm of ideas, as Plato contended. Its intelligentsia. Anaxagoras, a Greek philosopher of 3,000 years ago, rightly holds that the universe is the mind, which comprehends all creatures and all things, but only very few creatures within the universe comprehend and partake in the mind. There you have it, my friends, a quasi-philosophical answer to all of our existential questions. Whether one is blissfully ignorant, wrapped around fashion, sport, religion, etc., to make sense of it all, or miserably intelligent enough to recognize the futility or foolishness of the former, and to forever grapple with thoughts within the world of ideas, the larger percentage, that of the ignoramuses and the simpletons, who cling on dogmatically to religious or political ideologies, these populaces form the base, just as manure, dung, is needed in great quantities for flowers or for anything to bloom. When our world was young, the small percentage, its intelligentsia, if you like, sufficed to keep inanity, foolishness, at bay. But as we have progressively aged, at least in our planet, the collective reasoning capacity of humanity seems to have shrunken alarmingly, and we are now bordering on collective senility, something which comes with old age. So these are the thoughts I would like to share with you, wishing you a great day, and go on and serve your purpose on this planet, in this universe, to its fullest potential, my friends. Thank you for listening.